Good afternoon students, how are you all? I hope you are well and completing all your work on time and you have understood the concepts also nicely. You are revising your daily work. So we have completed two chapters of history by now and reading as well as question answers are done. Book work is also done and we have done with first chapter of civics, in which we have done the book work and question answers I will be giving you tomorrow. So you can write those questions in the same notebook of SST. We have to make only a single notebook of SST. Don't make three separate notebooks, but only in one notebook. Either you divide it into three parts or just continue with history, civics and geography as we go on. So that is up to you, whether you divide it into three or whether you continue the chapters. So before starting the geography chapter number 1, that is about the earth and solar system, that you might have already studied before in your previous class also, but there is some book map work that I want you to do. So we'll start with map work that is given on page number 10. Whatever I will write it here, only those things you will be marking in your map, and then after doing it you will be pasting it in your SST notebooks. So let us write down. You can note down the things in your rough copy or even at the back of your social studies copies. So just note down what you have to do from page number 10 of your Cordova books. You have to take a physical map of India. Physical map of India. On the physical, that is outline, in which boundaries are not given inside. So that is known as physical map of India. In this, I want you to mark some of the things. For example, you will mark down the rivers. That is, we have done river Indus, then river Ganga. You also have to draw the boundaries, since boundaries will not be drawn. Then river Yamuna. Then only then our book work or copy work of history will be complete, when we complete this map work. So three rivers I have given: Indus, Ganga, Yamuna. Then you will mark river Satluj also. Then river Jhelum. So these five rivers you are going to mark. Apart from that, I want you to mark in this map is what we have done: Garo Khasi Hills. So you will be marking Garo Hills. It's given in your book. You can take the help of your books. And it's on the western side. So then you will mark what we have done: Suleiman and Khitar Hills. So you are also going to mark Suleiman and it will be number 8. Khitar Hills, that is on the eastern side, now in Pakistan. So these are the 8 things that I want you to mark. Along with that, you will also mark the Deccan area. So it is given there. Just below the central Indian part, we have Deccan. Then you will mark in this, what I want you to mark is Vindhyas. We have already done Vindhyas in the central of the India. So these 10 things you are going to mark in the physical map of India. So this is your first map that you are going to do and then paste it in your notebooks, and it is to be done with the pencil only. So wherever you need to draw the boundaries of river Indus, Ganga, just mark them with pencil and write the name. So please do this work. And after that, I'll give you one another map, and that is on page number 15. So let us see now on page number 15, what you have to mark is, now it is political map of India, in which the inside boundaries will be given. to you, and for this map, what you will mark is, please note down, there are some sites that we have done, Paleolithic sites, Mesolithic sites, Neolithic sites, where the stone tools are found. So this, I want you to do it in the form of map. You will mark the places where the sites are there. First of all, we have done a very important site, that is Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh. So you will mark that. Just note it down, Bhimbetka. And there it is in Madhya Pradesh. We have done it. So you will mark this in your maps. Number two, what I want is, I want you to mark Mihargarh. That is in Pakistan now. It will be there in your books. Take the help of your book and mark it. Mihargarh. Then next I want you to mark is Chirand in Bihar. We'll be doing it. Then I want you to mark Daujli Heading, which is in Assam. Then I want you to mark, you will mark what? You will mark Yunzgai. We have done it. Where it is? In Karnataka. Then, after that, you are going to mark one more thing that I want is Bagaur in Rajasthan. So, this is what I want you to mark. Bagaur, it is in Rajasthan. Some of the sites we have done. Some of the sites I have already told you. The third chapter of history, it is based on Neolithic age. That is just related to the first two chapters. So that also will be taking up slowly after taking first chapter of geography. So that time you will come to know about the sites that are there, some of the sites. But still I want you to do it in the map so that we can proceed further. So these 6 plus 10 before of physical map, total 16 things I want you to mark in two maps, 10 in the physical map and 6 in the political map of India. So this is your homework, and you can complete it till next Thursday. You have enough time. Please do your work neatly and properly see the state where the site should be marked. So since it is a political map, it is very easy. You will not find any difficulty, but do it neatly with pencil. So now today I'll give you the introduction only of the first chapter of geography, but we will be taking it up in our upcoming videos. So let us start with the first chapter of geography. Today I'll just give you a brief introduction. What are we going to study in the chapter? What all is there in the chapter? When we look at the sky, what do we see? We see sun in the morning. In the night, we look at the stars, then the moon is there. But then we wonder, so many questions come into our mind. Where does the sun go in the night? Why does the stars twinkle? Why does the size of the moon changes? So all these questions are there in our mind, isn't it? And have you ever wondered from where do we get the answers? We get the answers from geography, because geography is a combination of two words. That is geo and graphic. Geo meaning earth and graphic meaning writing. So this means geography is nothing but the description of the earth. So in this subject we study about the earth. And earth is included with what? The sky, the planets, the sun, the asteroids, the comets, the meteoroids. So we will be studying all these things. The solar system, the 9 planets, the stars, the celestial or the heavenly bodies. Then how the universe came into being. We know that there is universe, but then how it came into being and when did it came into existence. So there are so many questions that have been there in our minds. But then this chapter, our earth and solar system, is answer to all these questions that have been there in our minds. So first of all, we are going to start with the universe. What is universe now? The first question, if we talk about, Universe is nothing but all the objects that I have just talked to you, like the sun, the moon, the stars, the asteroids, the satellites, the meteoroids, and then all the planets, the 8 planets that we have, all these are nothing but including your dust and gases that are there in the sky. They all form your universe. These objects are known as heavenly bodies that keep on rotating in the sky. The eight planets that we have now, they keep on rotating around the sun. So we'll be studying that, and sun is in the center. So universe is nothing but a group of all the objects like the sun, moon, stars, asteroids, meteoroids, then we have your satellites. So all these objects or celestial bodies or heavenly bodies make up your universe. Then a universe has a number of galaxies, and this galaxy is also known as Milky Way or Akash Ganga. What is the another name of this? It is Akash Ganga. We also call it Akash Ganga or Milky Way. So we have a number of galaxies in the universe that comprises of sun, the satellites, the moon, stars. So many stars are there in the galaxy. They are countless, limitless. So this is something about the universe, what it is comprised of, consist of. So then we'll talk about the origin of universe. How did it come into existence and when did it come into existence? So there are many questions and many views on this, but then we have come to the conclusion that the universe came into existence known as a Big Bang theory, that is 13.7 billion years ago. Just imagine how long our universe came into existence. It came into existence 13.7 billion years ago, and as a result of Big Bang theory. What is bang? As the name suggests, it is explosion. What happened suddenly? Maybe it might be possible that a hot ball of gases explode and it came into the existence of this universe. So that is known as Big Bang theory. So this is how a universe came into being. Then we'll study about the stars. As I have told you, they are limitless. Then we'll talk about the 8 system, our solar system with the sun as the center. We'll talk about the 8 planets, that is Venus, Mercury is there, then Earth is there, Saturn is there, then Neptune is there, Uranus we don't have now. So this way we'll study about Uranus is also there, and Saturn has rings. Which planet has how many rings and what is the length of each planet? So this way we'll study it in detail. So let us just recall the 8 planets that we have in our solar system. I have already told you about how universe came into existence and stars are there. Now stars, why are stars so small in size? They are very big actually in size, but then why they appear so small? They appear as small because they are far away from the Earth. And why sun is so big in size? Because it is nearer to the Earth. That is why it appears to us big. So there are 8 planets that revolve around the sun in their fixed orbits. So let us read the name, and I'll tell you a very easy way to remember all the names of these planets and also according to their positions in the solar system. Sometimes a question is asked, what place do we find Earth? In what place do we find Mars? In what place do we find Sun? So it will be easy for you to locate if you learn it in the way I tell you. It is just like a game. So let us see. You have to remember just one sentence and then you will never forget the position of the planets in the system. So M stands for Mercury. First, let me write down my very efficient mother just served us that you need to learn. It is just a sentence. My very efficient mother just served us nuts. If you remember this sentence, then you will remember the position. At first place, we have Mercury. Then we have Venus. V stands for Venus. E stands for Earth. He is on the third place. Then M stands for Mars. J stands for Jupiter. S stands for Saturn. U stands for Uranus. And then N is left out, which stands for Neptune. So this way, if you remember it, you will always remember the position of these planets in the system. My very efficient mother just served me nuts. So M is for Mercury, V for Venus, E for Earth, M for Mars, J for Jupiter, S for Saturn, U for Uranus, and N for Neptune. So this is the easy way to remember the position of the planets. Otherwise it is very very difficult. Even I forget which planet is where. So this way we can always recall it. So I hope this much is clear to you all. Apart from this, then we'll be studying about the constellations. What are constellations? Constellations are nothing but the shape or the pattern that the stars form at night. For example, we have so many patterns. If you look up the sky in the night today, just go outside and look up in the sky. You will be seeing a pattern or a shape formed by the stars. It can be in this way. It can be in this way. It can be a shape. So we have so many constellations in the sky. We will be studying all the names of this. Ursa Major is there. So all these are there. So we will be studying these constellations. Then apart from that, we'll be studying what are meteoroids, what are asteroids, then what are stars made up of. We'll be studying stars are made up of hot balls of gases and dust. So this is what I want you to learn till today. And if possible, just go through the first two or three pages of your geography chapter number 1. Then we'll be continuing up in the next video. So this was just a basic information or knowledge that I wanted you to provide today. So thanks for watching.